the shocking and extravagant paychecks of Kenya's lawmakers can no longer be hidden. Kenyan taxpayers are seething with anger and disgust as they struggle to make ends meet amid rising taxes and a flailing economy. Their elected members of parliament are living like royalty. They receive not just fat allowances, but also staff at their beck and call, and other elite privileges during and after their time in office. It's a lavish lifestyle that starkly contrasts with the harsh realities faced by the average Kenyan citizen. Shockingly, Kenya's members of parliament are amongst the highest paid in the world, surpassing even those in far wealthier developed countries such as the US or Germany. An independent study by the UK-based Independent Parliamentary Standard Authority Fund ranked Kenya's legislators as the second highest paid after Nigerians. The current monthly salary for an MP stands at Kenya shillings 725,522 or US dollars 5,690, inclusive of Kenya shillings 435,301 basic salary and housing allowance of Kenya shillings 150,000. However, due to their excessive allowances, a Kenyan MP from the far-flung northeastern region who attends all parliamentary committee meetings and holds a leadership position can comfortably earn more than Kenya shillings 2.5 million or US dollars 23,526 if they undertake official trips abroad. Dare I remind you, viewers, that all this is happening in a country facing severe debt and cost of living crisis, and where the vast majority of families can barely afford one square meal per day. Nairobi Senator Edwin Sifuna recently exposed the shocking extravagance in exaggerated allowances that run into millions of shillings, some going entirely unused throughout the MP's five-year terms. The first-term lawmaker and Senate Deputy Minority Whip shared his disbelief at the amount loaded onto his electronic toll collection ETC card for his parliamentary car. The ETC card is used exclusively by legislators to access the 27-kilometer expressway linking Nairobi CBD with Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. Here is what he said. I was shocked at the amount of money that is on my ETC card for my parliamentary car. As of this morning, there is Kenya shillings 377,000 on my ETC card, Sifuna revealed. I don't need all this money. Even if I drove up and down the expressway for a whole year, I would never exhaust the amount. We must do this so that we demonstrate to the people that we are serious. This is just one small example of the many expenses shouldered by Kenyan taxpayers. Expenses that have contributed to tax hikes so severe that they forced Kenyans to the streets in deadly demonstrations, claiming at least 41 lives. Another way the lawmakers line their pockets is through the millions they receive for mileage claims paid every month. MPs are presumed to travel every weekend to their constituencies, although this is rarely the case. This system has been largely abused, with lawmakers making claims for fictitious travel. A 2022-2023 audit revealed large-scale abuse of the mileage millions, with Auditor General Nancy Gathungu stating that most of the claims lacked supporting documents. Public Accounts Committee Chairman John Mbadi has recently admitted that some allowances are exaggerated given the state of the country's economy. "I cannot be a liar to tell you that salaries of Kenyan MPs are not high," he said. "If you look at our economy, the salary of an MP is high. It is not so sustainable." Apart from the monthly allowances, lawmakers continue to enjoy world-class medical treatment, including worldwide medical cover. They receive generous medical allowances for themselves, their spouses, and up to 5 children younger than 25 years. The superior medical cover includes Kenya shillings 10 million for inpatient care, Kenya shillings 300,000 for outpatient care, Kenya shillings 150,000 for maternity care, Kenya shillings 100,000 for dental services, and a similar amount for eye treatment. In addition to the lucrative allowances, MPs also enjoy a Kenya shillings 5 million official grant scheme to buy luxury cars every 5-year term, and a personal car loan from the government of up to Kenya shillings 8 million, repayable at 3% interest. Speakers receive up to Kenya shillings 40 million in mortgage and up to Kenya shillings 10 million for a car loan. Further overburdening the taxpayers is the excessive number of members of parliament. Kenyans are currently represented by 349 MPs in the National Assembly and 67 in the Senate. There are 1,450 members of county assemblies in the 47 devolved units. This level of representation is not only way too costly, but also redundant, adding an unnecessary burden to an already strained economy. This lavish lifestyle of Kenyan MPs, funded by the sweat and tears of hardworking citizens, is a slap in the face to every Kenyan struggling to make ends meet. While the legislators live like royalty, the average Kenyan bears the brunt of a failing economy and rising taxes. It is time for change. It is time the MPs are held accountable for the exorbitant paychecks and extravagant privileges they enjoy at the expense of the people they are supposed to serve. The time for change is now. Kenya needs leaders who are committed to serving the people, not exploiting them. What do you think about these shocking revelations? Should MPs' salaries be slashed to reflect the dire state of the economy? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more eye-opening content about Kenya. Until next time, stay informed and stay engaged. Thank you.